A force of 98 Newton is required to just start moving a body of mass 100 kg over ice. The coefficient of static friction is, so we know mu is equal to F upon R, mu is equal to F upon mg, force is 98 Newton, mass was 100 kg, which is equal to 0.1. So option D, 0.1 is the correct answer. Two balls of masses m1 and m2 are separated from each other by a powder charge placed between them. The whole system is at rest on the ground. Suddenly the powder charge explodes and mass are pushed apart. The mass m1 travels a distance s1 and stops if the coefficient of the friction between the ball and the ground are same. The mass m2 stops after traveling the distance. So we know that according to the given condition, s is inversely proportional to m square. So s2 upon s1 is equal to m1 upon m2 square. So s2 is equal to m1 upon m2 square into s1. So option C, S2 is equal to M1 square upon M2 square into S1 is the correct answer. A block of 1 kg is stopped against a wall by applying a force F perpendicular to the wall. If mu is equal to 0.2, then minimum value of F will be. So now to calculate minimum value of F, we know F is equal to W upon mu, where W is 1 into 9.8, that is mg. 0.2 value for mu is given, which is equal to 49 Newton. So option B, 49 Newton is the correct answer. A heavy uniform chain lies on a horizontal tabletop. If coefficient of friction between the chain and the table surface is 0.25, then maximum fraction of length of the chain that can hang over one edge of the table is. Now to calculate this, we know I dash is equal to, or L dash considering the length, mu upon mu plus 1 L, which is equal to 0.25 upon 0.25 plus 1 L, which is 1 by 5 L, or we can even write it as 20% of L. So option A, 20% of L is the correct answer. Question 5. The coefficient of static friction mu s between block A of mass 2 kg and the table as shown in the figure is 0.2. What would be the maximum mass value of block B so that the two blocks do not move? The string and the pulley are assumed to be smooth and the massless. G is equal to 10 meter per second square. Now to solve this question, we know mu is equal to mb upon MA. So 0.2 is equal to MB upon 2. So value for MB is 0.4 kg. So option D, 0.4 kg is the correct answer. Question 6. A horizontal force of 10 Newton is necessary to just hold a block stationary against a wall. The coefficient of friction between the block and the wall is 0.2. The weight of the block is. Now to calculate the weight of the block, we know force acting F is equal to W upon mu, where weight W is equal to mu into F. Coefficient of friction given is 0.2 and force acting is 10, which on solving we get 2 Newton. So option A, 2 Newton is the correct answer. Question 7. A 20 kg block is initially at rest on a rough horizontal surface. A horizontal force of 75 Newton is required to set the block in motion. After it is in motion, a horizontal force of 60 Newton is required to keep the block moving with constant speed. The coefficient of static friction is. Now we know coefficient of static friction is given by mu s, which is F1 upon R, which is 75 upon mg, 75 upon 20 into 9.8, which is equal to 0.38. So option A, 0.38, is the correct answer. Question 8. A boy of mass 40 kg is climbing a vertical pole at constant speed. If the coefficient of friction between his palm and the pole is 0.8 and g is equal to 10 meter per second square, the horizontal force that he is applying on the pole is. Now, here mu is equal to 0.8. Let F be the horizontal force. Let F be the horizontal force that the boy is applying on the pole. Various forces are acting on the boy. Mg is the weight, normal reaction N. So frictional force F is equal to mu N, which is equal to Mg. So N is equal to Mg upon mu, 40 into 10 upon 0.8, which is equal to 500 Newton. So F is equal to N is equal to 500 Newton. So option C, 500 Newton, is the correct answer. Question 9. A man drags a block through 10 meter on rough surface, mu is equal to 0.5. A force of root 3 kN acting at 30 degree to the horizontal. The work done by applied force is. F sin 30. F cos 30. F is equal to root 3 kN. The components of applied force F in the direction of motion is F cos 30. The work done by applied force is W is equal to F cos 30 into S, work done force into displacement, root 3 into 10 raised to 3 into root 3 by 2 into 10 joules, which on solving we get 15 into 10 raised to 3 joules, which is equal to 15 kilojoules. So option B, 15 kilojoules, is the correct answer. Question 10. A block of mass 5 kg is on a rough horizontal surface and is at rest. Now a force of 24 newton is imparted to it with negligible impulse. If the coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.4 and g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square, then acceleration of the block is. Now we know that net force is equal to applied force minus friction force. Force mass into acceleration is equal to 24 minus mu mg. 24 minus mu is 0.4 into 5, mass is 5 and g is 9.8, which on solving we get 24 minus 19.6. So A is equal to 4.4 upon 5, which is equal to 0.88 meter per second square. So option D, 0.88 meter per second square, is the correct answer. Question 11. A body of mass 2 kg is being dragged with uniform velocity of 2 meters per second on a rough horizontal plane. The coefficient of friction between the body and the surface is 0.20. The amount of heat generated in 5 seconds is. Now we know work done is force into displacement, mu mg into v into t. W is equal to 0.2 into 2 into g is 9.8 into 5. Heat generated Q is equal to W upon J, work done upon joules. 0.2 into 2 into 9.8 to 2 into 5 divided by 4.2. The value for J is given is equal to 9.33 calories. So option A, 9.33, is the correct answer. 9.33 calories is the correct answer. Question 12. Two carts of masses 200 kg and 800 kg on horizontal rails are pushed apart. Suppose the coefficient of friction between the carts and the rail are same. If 200 kg cart travels a distance of 36 meter and stops, then the distance traveled by cart weighing 300 kg is. Now to solve this question, we know, according to the condition, S is inversely proportional to m square, S2 upon S1 is equal to m1 upon m2 square, which is equal to 200 upon 300 square. So S2 is equal to S1 into 4 by 9, 36 into 4 by 9, which is equal to 16 meter. So option C, 16 meter, is the correct answer. Question 13. A car turns a corner on a slippery road at a constant speed of 10 meter per second. If the coefficient of friction is 0.5, the minimum radius of the arc in meter in which the car turns is 20. Is now to solve this question, we know V is equal to square root of mu rg, r is equal to v square upon mu g, is equal to 100 upon 0.5 into 10, which is equal to 20. So option A, 20, is the correct answer. Question 14. A body of 10 kg is acted by a force of 129.4 newton. If g is equal to 9.8 meter per second, the acceleration of the block is 10 meter per second square. What is the coefficient of kinetic friction? So we know net force acting is equal to applied force minus friction. So MA is equal to F minus mu k mg, where mu k is equal to F minus MA upon mg. 129.4 minus 10 into 10 upon 10 into 9.8, which is equal to 0.3. So option C, 0.3, is the correct answer. Question 15. Consider a car moving along a straight horizontal road with speed of 72 km per hour. If the coefficient of kinetic friction between the tires and the road is 0.5, the shortest distance in which the car can be stopped is. Now to solve this question, we know S is equal to u square upon 2 mu g, 20 square upon 2 into 0.5 into 10, which is equal to 40 meter. So option B, 40 meter, is the correct answer. Question 16. A 500 kg horse pulls a cart of mass 1500 kg along a level road with an acceleration of 1 meter per second raised to minus 2. If coefficient of sliding friction is 0.2, then the force exerted by the horse is forward direction is. Now we know net force in forward direction is equal to accelerating force plus friction, which is equal to MA plus mu mg. M can be taken common from here. In brackets, we get A plus mu g, which is 1500 plus 500, 1 plus 0.2 into 10, which is equal to 2000 into 3, which is equal to 6000 newton. So option D, 6000 newton, is the correct answer. Question 17. A body of weight 64 newton is pushed with just enough force to start it moving across a horizontal floor, and the same force continues to act afterwards. If the coefficient of static and dynamic friction are 0.6 and 0.4 respectively, the acceleration of the body will be. So weight of the body is 64 newton. So mass of the body M is equal to 6.4 kg. Mu is equal to 0.6, mu k is equal to 0.4, net acceleration is equal to applied force minus kinetic friction, applied force minus kinetic friction upon mass of the body, which is equal to mu s mg minus mu k mg upon it, mu s minus mu k into g, m gets cancelled, which is equal to 0.6 minus 0.4 into g, which is equal to 0.2g. So option D, 0.2g, is the correct answer. Question 18. A block of mass 10 kg is placed on a rough horizontal surface having coefficient of friction mu, which is equal to 0.5. If a horizontal force of 100 newton is acting on it, then acceleration of the block will be. So now to solve this question, we know acceleration A is equal to applied force minus kinetic friction upon mass, which is equal to 100 minus 0.5 into 10 into 10 upon 10, which is equal to 5 meter per second square. So option B, 5 meter per second square, is the correct answer. Question 19. A marble block of mass 2 kg lying on ice, when given a velocity of 6 meter per second, is stopped by friction in 10 seconds. Then the coefficient of friction is. So we know that V is equal to U minus AT. U minus mu GT is equal to 0. So mu is equal to U upon GT, which is equal to 6 upon 10 into 10, which is 0.06. So option D, coefficient of friction is 0.06. 20. A car having a mass of 1000 kg is moved at a speed of 30 meters per second. Brakes are applied to bring the car to rest. If the frictional force between the tire and the road surface is 5000 newtons, the car will come to rest in dash. Now to solve this question, we know that U or V is equal to U plus AT. So T can be written as U upon A, as V is equal to 0. So T is equal to mu U into M upon F, which is equal to 30 into 1000 upon force acting is 5000 newtons, which in solving we get 6 seconds. So option D, 6 seconds, is the correct answer. Question 21. A body of mass 5 kg rests on a rough horizontal surface of coefficient of friction 0.2. The body is pulled through a distance of 10 meters by a horizontal force of 25 newton. The kinetic energy acquired by it is. So we know that kinetic energy acquired by the body is equal to total work done by the body. Total work done on the body minus work done against friction. Work done again. Friction against friction. So which is equal to F into S minus mu mgs. 25 into 10 minus 0.2 into 5 into 10 into 10, which on solving we get 250 minus 100, which gives us 150 joules. So option B, 150 joules, is the correct answer. Question 22. A motorcyclist traveling on a curved track of radius 500 meter, if the coefficient of friction between road and the tire is 0.5, the speed avoiding skidding will be. Now we know mu V is equal to square root of mu rg, square root of 0.5 into 500 into 10, which gives us 50 meter per second. So option A, 50 meter per second, is the correct answer. Question 23. A fireman of mass 60 kg slides down a pole. He is pressing the pole with a force of 600 newton. The coefficient of friction between the hands and the pole is 0.5. With what acceleration will be the fireman slide down? So now we know net downward acceleration. Net downward acceleration is equal to weight minus frictional force upon mass, mg minus mu r upon m. So 60 into 10 minus 0.5 into 600 upon 60, 300 upon 60, is equal to 5 meter per second square. So option D, 5 meter per second square is the correct answer. Question 24. A body is moving along a rough horizontal surface with an initial velocity 6 meter per second. If the body comes to rest after traveling 9 meters, then the coefficient of sliding friction will be. So we know S is equal to U square upon 2 mu g. Mu can be written as U square upon 2 gs. 6 square upon 2 into 10 into 9. Which I'm solving, we get 0.2. So option B, 0.2 is the correct answer. Question 25. Consider a car moving on a straight road with speed of 100 meter per second. The distance at which car can be stopped is mu k is equal to 0.5. So we know S is equal to u square upon 2 mu g. 100 square upon 2 into 0.5 into 10. Which is equal to 1000 meter. So option D, 1000 meter is the correct answer. Question 26. A block B is pushed momentarily along a horizontal surface with an initial velocity V. If mu is the coefficient of sliding friction between B and the surface, block B will come to rest after a time. Initial velocity should be U. Now to solve this question, we know friction is the retarding force for the block. So F is equal to ma, which is equal to mu r equated with mu mg. A, that is retardation, mu g. From the first equation to motion, we know v is equal to u minus at. 0 v minus, so initial velocity we can consider v also, v minus mu g into t. T is equal to 0. T is equal to v upon mu g. So option A, v upon mu g is the correct answer. Question 27. An iron block of mass 5 kg is kept on a trolley. The trolley is being pushed with an acceleration of 5 meter per second square. What will be the force of friction between the block and the trolley surface? Take coefficient of static friction between the block and the surface to be 0.8. Now to solve this question, we know mass is equal to 5 kg. Acceleration is equal to 5 meter per second square. F is equal to ma 5 into 5, which is equal to 25 meters. So fr is equal to F. So fr is also equal to 25 newton. So option D, 25 newton is the correct answer. Question 28. A conveyor belt is moving at a constant speed of 2 meter per second. A box is gently dropped on it. The coefficient of friction between them is mu is equal to 0.5. The distance that the box will move relative to the belt before coming to rest on it, taking g is equal to 10 meter per second inverse, is. So a is equal to mu g, which is equal to 5. V square is equal to u square plus 2 as. 0 is equal to 2 square plus 2 into 5 into s. So s is equal to minus 2 by 5 with respect to the belt. Or distance is equal to 0.4 meter. So option B, 0.4 meter is the correct answer. Question 29. Starting from rest, a body slides down a 45 degree inclined plane in twice the time it takes to slide down the same direction, same distance, in the absence of friction. The coefficient of friction between the body and the inclined plane is. So we know mu is equal to tan theta 1 minus 1 upon n square. Theta is equal to 45 degree given in the question. And n is equal to 2. Twice the time. So mu is equal to tan 45. 1 minus 1 upon 4. 1 minus 1 upon 4 is equal to 3 by 4. Which is equal to 0.75. So option C, 0.75 is the correct answer. Question 30. The coefficient of friction between a body and the surface of an inclined plane at 45 degree is 0.5. If g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square, the acceleration of the body downwards in meter per second square is a is equal to g sine theta minus mu cos theta 9.8 into sine 45 minus 0.5 cos 45, which is equal to 4.9 upon root 2 meter per second square. So option A, 4.9 upon root 2 is the correct answer.